Yeezy 451. Are you a fan of these? I'm not really a fan of these. They debuted, I think, during Paris Fashion Week again. Kanye was jumping out of his cab somewhere and trying to avoid the rain. And everyone was kind of looking at his feet and he had these weird leather tracks. Kanye loved leather pants, didn't it? I wonder what the leather pants thing's about. Is that like a rock thing? Is that like a... if it's not a rock thing, is that like just a kind of a swaggy luxury thing, right? When you've had all the jeans in the world, when you've bought all the RRPs, when you bought all the Visvim jeans, you bought all the neighborhood jeans, you bought every kind of raw denim jean that's available, that's sick out there. The only other logical place to go to is to buy tailored trousers, right? Or to buy really, ridiculous, you know, pleated Issey Miyake sort of like pants that cost you $1,000, whatever it may be, right? Or to buy shitty designer jeans, or to just go the other way and just buy some amazing leather pants that are all one of one. They don't make many of them, you know, they source the best leathers, all that blah, blah. Maybe it's part of it, I don't know, but I've never really been the biggest, especially the way he wears them. I'm a fan of like the conventional kind of Ramstein look leather jeans, right? Like massive leather jeans with like, you know, maybe like a, maybe I'm thinking of Chrome Hearts, like simple, like flared or kind of, you know, 99%, maybe the Soloist sort of like leather pants where they're kind of, you know, really rough looking, they're kind of raw, they don't have many embellishments, there's no funky zips, no weird paneling, just really stuck to you, they fit you like a glove. They work really well with New York boots or some massive Dr. Martens, right, or some other kind of, you know, combat ready trainers. And they just get you up. You just get up and go, right? I like those kind of things. But Kanye obviously prefers a more luxury thing looking. But he debuted them during Paris Fashion Week. This colorway I'm not a fan of. I think I remember seeing the colorway before when they were kind of got leaked. I was a fan of those more. But these look wild. And again, I think that's a good thing. I'm happy about Kanye existing in this sneaker space at the moment. Say what you like about Yeezy. You can like it. You can not like it. What he has been doing. He has been kind of, because I remember there was a point in time, especially when Kanye and Don C and those guys were heavily wearing retro Jordan 4s, right? There was a time where I was kind of a bit like, I was a bit tired of like, it was only retros that were coming out, right? And some of the retros that they were bringing out, with the exception of Jordans, I think of some of the Air Maxes that came out, the Air Max Lights and shit. Nike were doing such a bad job of retroing them, right? They were coming out with the banana shapes, the paneling was off. Like, everything was just rubbish, right? And they came out with these shitty excuses that, oh, the tooling is gone. We don't have the tooling. It costs a lot. Bruv, you're Nike. You're a billion-dollar company. Remake the tooling. Buy an old pair off eBay and redo them. Like, come on, man. Use your common sense. You know what I mean? Or just do them anyway. Serve the sneakerheads what they can serve. But they did, like, the least amount of effort and just put them out. So that for Kanye to go to Adidas and to purposely not do the easy thing, which would be to go to the archive and take some, because Adidas has some fucking killer stuff in the archive, right? You could have taken some really underrepresented or shoes that didn't get the love that they needed at the time, shoes, put his kind of Yeezy stamp on it and put them out, and they would have sold out the same way. But he challenged himself and created a whole different silhouette, a whole different approach to sneakers. And they look nothing like anything else on the market. So much so that when someone makes a shoe that looks like a Yeezy, the first thing you say is it look like a Yeezy. No Yeezy looks like another brand, unless you look at maybe the 700s or something, right? That might look like something like a New Balance. But everything has its really unique sort of like vibe and look to it. And I think that's what I have to give Kanye props to, regardless if you like it or not. And it's another shoe in that kind of ilk. It's a 451 Yeezy. It's got this weird sort of like volcanic footbed on it, where it sort of like encapsulate the whole upper, like it's kind of like a, it reminds of like, you remember Venom in Spider-Man, right, when the kind of thing is, the ink thing is crawling all over you and it kind of seeps into your eye. That's what it kind of reminds of, like it could take over the entire body. It would be quite cool if they had an outfit or look that actually had that level of weird melty vibe and flames that kind of went all the way up the trouser and connected to the jacket, some kind of modular thing. It reminds me of something that Ita Thorpe would really be good at, right? Remember Ita Thorpe was doing stuff at Stone Island and Umbro? Like, that would be something he'd be really cool at. Somehow making an outfit or suit that kind of melds, that kind of joins in with the shoe and sort of like a one piece. That would be pretty sick. But anyway, Kanye decided to debut a pair of Nubuck suede, it looks like, right? 451s, right? It's really old to shoot. Of course, he's making them, so it doesn't matter. But in the rain in Paris, right? It's fucking, the flagrancy is up on another level, isn't it? And again, I like the old model of the shoe. I probably don't like the colorway. I like the fact that they've got this weird thing where it looks as if like the heel and the foot don't land on the floor. instead you're walking on your forefoot, it looks like. Sort of, so it's sort of like got like a bit of a moon shape at the bottom. I quite like that look of it. This is an article from Paris Fashion, from Sneaker News. It says Kanye West debuts the Yeezy 451 at Paris Fashion Week. Each showing up of the previous energy, this year's Serious Fashion Weeks is undoubtedly one of the... What? This writing is weird. Anyway, but off to the side, even far away from the front row, Kanye walked the streets of Paris in an unreleased Yeezy silhouette. One simply dubbed the Yeezy 451. Visually removed from anything in the current lineup, the pair swaps tooling from one highly aggressive... with its various molds extending upwards into a woven upper in angular spikes. Its base, which tints yellow here, ostensibly constructs minimal as color is blocking. This English is weird. Anyway, let's continue looking at the pictures. So yeah, the pants I'm not a fan of. The outfit I'm not a fan of at all. He does that weird thing how he walks in it. He's having his mouth open, slumps his shoulder and does that. I don't know what that thing's about, but the shoes look fucking banging. He somehow avoided that massive puddle. It looks like a fucking ocean. And again, I'm a big fan of it, man. These guys all look like former special forces guys, isn't it? They got that special forces bum where it's all like high and tight. But yeah, no homo there aside. I love the shoe. I'm a big fan of it. It looks like nothing else available now in the market. He's a great person to kind of debut shoes in that regard, right? He knows how to kind of floss and to kind of present shoes in a good way and kind of get them viral on the internet. You know, here he is and he's amazing. And he's, you know, he's an amazing outfit. Not for me, but I like the fact that he kind of came out in the flipping. Is that like a Nubuck baseball shirt? It's kind of shirt, leather pants, and you know, Nubuck suede shoes in the rain in Paris. But yeah, I like the model of it. It looks very slim, a very straight sort of shoe. It looks like a low for the most part. I don't see the padding going up here on a high, so it's probably a low shoe. But again, I think another colorway with maybe some contrast on the flames would work better for me. But again, I'm interested to see what it looks like going forward. But I think it looks pretty interesting, man, for the sake of it. So yeah, big up Kanye for again pushing the limits again when it comes to sneaker design and not having the conventional samey kind of look, right? Because it could be easy to do that, but instead he always kind of goes for the jugular and tries things a little bit more difficult.